Hi there guys, today we're going to be talking about a very interesting and very charismatic species, the yellowfin tuna. Yellowfin, otherwise known as gas bottles or the big nduna. Basically, shape-wise, they, as the gas bottle nickname would refer to, they're very, very rounded in shape and very, very streamlined. Actually, if you look on the side of a yellowfin, he's got a spot where his pectoral fins will fold in and it forms an absolutely flush little mount there on the side. So very aerodynamic, very water dynamic. And as that shape suggests, they're very, very quick. They move fast through the waters, and that's all about how they hunt. They're not ambush hunters. They actively chase down their prey. Scientific name, Tunis albicaris. They occur in big schools. They're not individual hunters. How they go about hunting is they actually trap bait balls. So you often see if bait's very loose in the water, not very closely packed together, it's not being hunted. And as soon as the predators start circling it, they get very close together. And that's how the tuna feed, similar to dolphins. They actually pick themselves together and they pick off bait one at a time as they go around. Mentioning the dolphins, that's one of the best ways of targeting them with if you're a ski boat fisherman. As soon as you see the dolphins, the yellowfin often chase and follow the dolphins wherever they go, because they know as soon as the dolphins find the fish, or bait fish at least, they're going to be scraps left for them and fish to feed on. So what you do is you get yourself a nice popper. As soon as you see the dolphins, you follow them, and when they start feeding or when they start moving in the same area repeatedly, not blitzing for the horizon, throw your popper and work it very slowly through that area. In terms of their growth rate, they're extremely fast growing. They are pelagic species, so they uptake a lot of food very quickly and grow very quickly. They can absorb angling pressure very well, so it's one of the species we'd recommend you targeting, because they can actually take in that, or deal with the increased angling pressure that that we have nowadays with the overpopulation. They attain, the maximum length that's been recorded is 2.2 meters to the fork length, and that's about 190 kgs. So the ones we get here off the coast, a big fish is normally about 25 kilos off KZN. Off Cape Town, where they have the really big boys, a fish of 100 kilos is a big fish. So we've got the little juveniles here, but up towards Richards Bay, where there's a bit of a drop off, the guys are now more frequently catching the big fish up to like 60 kilos. But yeah, your normal fish that you get off KZN are around about the 10, 14 kilo range. That's a normal sized tuna. The biggest ever recorded was a fish caught in Mexico in 2012. That fish was 193.7 kilos, which is an absolute giant of a tuna. If you know how strong a 14 kilo tuna is, you can just imagine how strong one of 190 is. In terms of maturity, after 2 years they mature, which is about a meter long in length, so they grow, as you can see, they grow very quickly. They occur from the shallow water all the way down to about 350 meters depth, but they have put tracking tags in them before, and they found that they do sometimes dive down to over a kilometer in depth. So they're really good at processing the oxygen and keeping the oxygen in their blood. That's why they have such red meat. In terms of targeting, they're targeted by the commercial side of things in a few different ways. Seine netting, so that's actually where they find the tuna school and they put a net around the entire school like that, and then they lift up the net. They catch them in trawl nets, not as much because they do move away. Obviously it's more for slower species when they trawl a net. They catch them pole fishing. So that's a very interesting style actually. They got a boat that sprays water from around the whole boat, into water jets into that, and that simulates what bait fish would do when they're jumping. So the tuna come up with that. These guys have very long poles, probably about 4 meters in length, just with a piece of nylon and a little lure on it, just with a hook. They dip this in, and you would have seen this on YouTube before. If not, have a look at it, pole line fishing for tuna. And these guys just whip the tuna over their head like that as they catch them. So that's one of the most sustainable ways of catching the tuna. And then also by trawling lures and things like that. Recreational side, for ski boats, live bait works very well for them. Trawling with a live bait on a 6-0 circle, just with straight nylon. And that's anywhere around your bait marks. So number one in Durban, very good spot, T-barge, another one. Trawling your live baits around there. Also, as we mentioned, throwing the poppers for around your dolphins. And then trawling lures is an extremely effective way of finding the tuna. Because once you can trawl at speed and get and move around until you locate where the tuna are, and then you can target that specific area and actually catch more. For your shore-based guys, we do actually catch a few tuna a year. One of the hotspots is probably down in Port Edward, Splash Rock. Probably get the most tuna of any spot, really, along our KZN coast. And there, really, a live bait can't be beaten. If you can get it out with a kite into further distance or a drone nowadays, that's going to really, really up your chances. But yeah, the guys that slide live baits, live shad, live carantine, that kind of thing, they do catch a few every year. Other hot spots along the coast as well, Stiebel or Stabel down Pumula, your Orange Rocks, Yuvongo, Pothole, that kind of area, and Scottborough are the other. So those top four spots would be the, if you want to target them from the shore, that's the place to go. If you can move further afield, Mozambique, the kind of areas up far north into the tropical regions, throwing spoons, throwing poppers, that kind of thing is going to be the way to go. Yellowfin is pretty much a giant ball of muscle. He is extremely strong, he's got a very strong tail, and he doesn't give up. So you have to have stout tackle. For the big boys down in the Cape, we're talking 50W size as a minimum, and then moving up from there. Here we've got our tuna ski rod, which is about a 20 kilo rod, is thereabouts where you want to be. And you don't necessarily need a lot of capacity, but you do need the backbone to be able to get him up. Shore based, it's going to be mix and match your general live bait purpose rod, your medium type, 6 to 8 ounce type rod. For sliding, and if you're throwing lures to the saltest to use from the shore, probably the slim power spin rod, and that's either in the 11.6 or the 12.6 depending on your view on life, if you're a glass half empty or half full kind of guy, or girl. So yeah, that's if you want to catch them. The KZN, as I said, is generally where the smaller guys are, but they're more abundant, and then down in the Cape you're getting the really big boys. If they are migratory species, they do move around, but it's one of the guys that you can catch pretty much all year round on a ski boat. So yeah, get your lures. Our Rattler range is very, very good for them. The 130 size in the pink, or there's a purple with black stripe on it that has proven very, very deadly for them. Also, they're not that expensive, which works out very well, because often with tuna come sharks, so you do get taxed quite a bit. Trawl your lures, find the fish, put out your live baits and drift through the same area, and you're guaranteed to get a few. It's one of the best species to catch. You can go very light on them if you want to and mess around, but if the sharks are around, don't waste the fish. Put your heavy tackle on, get the fish out. Yellowfin tuna, go out and enjoy. Cheers.